from them, I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John Lemp. I won't retreat. Hello, my name is John
Lemp. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now. Our tour begins here in this gallery, where you see paintings of some of our guests as they appeared in their corruptible, mortal state. Your cadaverous pallor betrays an aura of foreboding, almost as though you sense a disquieting metamorphosis.
Have some vittles, a little bit of fun, that's all. Sometimes in this world, you want what you want. You want what you want. You gotta get what you want. Oh, geez, boy.
Thank you.
automatons. Now I want you to do it. Now smell my fingers. Smell my fingers. Okay, back there. He was racing around the stage like a little animal, and I had to treat him like one. See, this is a family. That's the boy. That's the pile. And that's the gun range guy. He is one of the world's foremost sharpshooters. True story. It's all about the apricot, if you know what I'm saying. Does everybody know about the kill shot? Yeah. Okay. I might have a music kill shot on you some boy. Now, let's do some dance time. A little bit of dancing. Thank you. draws lands on our skin and feeds on our fate. For those who remember, it causes their pain. Makes us worry at its seems, forces us to worry, this threat through night and day, it's all not a patient, no price to pay. And so that little bit of music there was my attempt, for some of you who brought nice looking females with you, that was my hope that you might get a little later. Because you can say, you know, well, I didn't take you to a date movie, but did you hear that one song? But this one here is called Call Me Up, and this is my public service announcement. See, I've noticed some trends in our society that it seems like, well, at least a quarter or a third of the male population is probably gonna do some time in the next 20 years. So I wanna get y'all ready to be ass fucked. Because you're gonna go somewhere where you get a lot of that. You're either giving a lot of it or you're receiving a lot of it, but there's a lot of it. And so what better way while you're out here on the outside with all the freebies, you know, the civvies, what better way to get, you know, ready, kind of prepare the lingo, the point of view. Call some gay phone sex lines. Live men, live chat, any hour, it's good. This is just my attempt to prepare some people. Call me up, I'll break you in the morning. That's as good as it gets right there.
Yeah.
I turned my back for one, well, you don't know what that means. I might have needed to read the sports page. The sticks. Well, every now and then he's got to pull his britches up. And I wanna especially thank our very own, well, he's our helper and duo man. I call him Utter Rubber. He's got a big old can of bag balm, and he helps me hold the humping calf every now and then. Oh yeah, like you've never done it, huh? Everybody fucks a farm animal now and then. Don't knock it till you try it. Utter Rubber. Well, chicken feces, but other than that, it's great. Hey, can we hear this? Superstar from the past. But in that scene, he actually utters the words, "Now come on down here and eat my pussy." Can you imagine hearing that out of Mickey Rourke's mouth? And I don't know what the boy's doing watching stuff like that. What are we doing, Lennon? I'm supposed to keep him away from the bad things in the world. You know, I gotta keep him out of that. But now that you mention it, don't we have a song about ass fucking coming up? Oh, we already did that one.
breathing. I'm gonna get some. placentas. She'd fry them up deep and crispy. An old Earl.
Earl with his bald head! With the wax he built up and the warts and the moles, and we used to scrape it and scrape it and scrape it, but now we'd cut him.
Every now and then we'd cut him real deep and he'd get a little bit upset. Well, that's okay, though. And there was old Willie.
Willie didn't walk so well there at the end. I think it had something to do with him really owing me a duct tape to a lawn chair.
Up in the backyard.
Confused lemonade. Until he pissed all over himself. Drop!
Harris Ranch? You know what that place is, right?
Yeah.
Kauschwitz? Huh? Slaughterer?
Yeah,
Slaughterer. Just on its own level. So clean and pure. Well, that's one story, but... See, we were driving one night and we heard this sound. It was dark out, we had the windows down, you know, couldn't tell if it was pinchy breaking wind or the cows. I didn't know what was going on. So we were trying to reach some kind of equilibrium. And we hear this sound off in the distance. Myself a 64-ounce Cutting Glusher load of soda, you know. I'm all binged up because I've been eating nothing but beef jerky and nuts, and you know, I'm looking for help over the weekend. So I asked the guy behind the counter. I say, "What's that sound I'm hearing off in the distance?" And he tells me the most delightful tale of a man. A dairy farmer with a magnet in his hand. Do you know what dairy farmers do with big magnets? They tool the anus of the milk cows. You see, milk cows munch and munch and munch away at the hay, and they can't help but gather pieces of baling wire. And over the months, time after time, of the baling wire being ingested, they get a wrapped up, binged up belly. And they just die. So, you gotta tool the anus for the wire. You know? Just punch it in real deep. Tug it on out. Well, this farmer picked the wrong fucking cow. It's the ghost of that man gasping for air up the ass of a cow. Isn't that nice? Well, guess how we get them back? How do we get those cows back? With the stainless steel bolt. Stainless steel bolt, air-driven shaft, straight through the skull. Life comes to pass. Constantly fed for maximum girth, so an arch golden sign or eat a zillion. Served.
I don't know. Thank you. There goes the set list in that car. Oh my God.
Yeah, so that was up there the whole time?
No, no.
Oh, it's Pinch. It's Pinch eating cookies. Oh, come on.
Let's go on.
Okay, then I'm feeling John.
Binge and grab someday.
Binge 10,000.
Binge 10.
Get ready now. Like they've got like a whole line of people ready to intercept. Look at that.
It started. He's gone.
So this is your third and final chance.
Thanks, baby.
I didn't even know. No, I got it. Thanks for the treats and the fun times. I know.
Just gonna pull the van forward a little bit if you guys want yourself.
Sure.
Thanks for a great show.
Thanks, Buck.
Thanks, baby.
Bucket.
All right.
Oh, Bucket.
You signed Buckethead?
Yeah. Cool.
All right, guys.
I gotta get Buckethead's autograph.
Thank you, Buckethead.
Buckethead fucking card, bro.
Totally.
Thanks, Maximum.
Thanks, Bob.
Bob?
Dude,
thank
Bob.
You. Hey, Bob.
Kick ass, man.
Great job, man.
Thanks.
Rock and roll, bro.
Can I live here?
Yeah.
You gotta wear a sweatshirt.
Oh, it's so hot here, though.
It is. Yeah, stoked you guys came to town, man.
You gotta come more often.
Do more often?
I don't
think you will.
Oh, yeah.
If you build
right.
it, they will come.
That's
right. Is that the fucking Queasy Bank?
Yeah.
Dude,
this is Queasy Bank.
Queasy cakes.
Bucket's gonna
Bucket,
love
I
this.
Bucket, I just want to give you a hug when you're done.
Those, you might be hungry on the road.
I don't want
to pick them. It's a gift right now. Never seen Buckethead without a bucket on his head.
Then you know what?
I picture the bucket.
I could take a digital picture of him.
Because some of us, like, take his face and find out where he lives and follow him home.
God, good Lord. Oh, that's terrible. Oh.
We love you no matter what you look
get the saw. Start talking like that.
It's crazy
talk. It's crazy talk.
It's crazy talk.
Can I give you a hug? You got the cap?
Buckethead, man.
Why was it too hard to watch?
Hey, Sarah. Ready?
Yeah, it's Sarah.
He's cracking his thumb.
Would you take a picture of me on Buckethead?
Sure.
On this?
Oh, it's okay.
Buckethead, will you sign my ass?
Uh-oh.
It's Darren. That's a problem. Thank you very much.
Can you use that pen on mine? Buckethead?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My name is Bubba. Buckethead. Go ahead and
you got on card. Oh, this is the real thing. Hold it down.
Hold it down.
There you go.
Thanks, Buckethead. Good show, man.
Buckethead.
good I brought these. I thought you might be.
Sweet.
You're signing these? That Cobra Strike. Dan Robot.
Mike, I want a picture with Mike.
Oh, you're in.
Mike, will you sign my thank you?
Hey, Buck, I'm working on a book about your music, by the way. I'll send you a copy to Chris so you can look at it.
Thank you.
When you want to get a ride to the space station, just let us know.
If anybody else needs a pen, you have it.
Yes, right here. Digital. Hang on, let me do one more here.
We take mine too. Excuse me.
Yep. That's it. I got one.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you guys later.
Don't forget the quiz. NASA. Love you guys. See you guys. Okay, let's see that bottle now.
Here's the bottle. It's the official Buckethead drinking unit.
Wow.
Nice. Right from the stage. I saw some guy get the set list.
Yeah, man. I mean, no, Eddie fucking gay. He's like, dude, you want Buckethead shit? This is what you want.
Let's
fucking search this
here. Really? Yeah, well,
yes, I think it would be wonderful to hook you up with it. So let's take our picture together.
Rabid Buckethead fans all around, everywhere. It's crazy. We're all nuts.
Yeah, yeah. That was good shit.
Yeah.
Time to leave.